really like the kind of grayscale, almost like blue green tint to the beginning of it when they were kind of exploring through the woods. The underwater scene, I mean, come on. Oh, it was just mesmerizing. And I love the scene of the two of them ascending up to the top of the water together, like right in like parallel to each other. It was beautiful. And then when they emerge, and then there's this gorgeous new scene of like mountains and snowscape, and it was absolutely stunning. I really, really enjoyed this film. I loved the costuming, especially the, you know, kind of tattered netting that they were wearing. Really, really great job. The sound was incredible. The performances, of course, stunning. These two dancers are so talented. And just what a beautiful use of like gorgeous location.
I think there's this sort of fantasy, whimsical, childlike energy that comes within this piece. We see these two gentlemen who are having a moment of contemporary and experimental dance between these parts of nature. And one of my most exciting favorite bits was when they were in this forest and they were amongst this moment of water and clay, and they rub their bodies full of the clay. They lay down, they laugh, so to speak, and then they curl up into this ball in the middle of darkness. I feel like that was a very childlike type moment to be expressed. You know, they keep their legs together and have it crossed as if they have a fin, which I thought was an interesting element to have despite not having the fins. They did. It was an interesting take. Honestly, it's not one I've seen, but I'm surprised I haven't seen it.
The way it's color treated is really well too. You get, it's kind of got this very cinematic LUT to it. The movements were great. The use of that space was just fantastic. Really getting in on the ground there, in the water, all the way all that came together, I thought was just amazing. People are definitely out there doing things I would never even imagine. So it's great because, you know, we're treated to all this beautiful footage, a great dance, and people that are really committed and into their performances.
The cinematography alone with the lighting, especially starting in the forest, and you're hearing all of the sounds of the birds and their footfalls, it was just really crisp and clear and gorgeous. And then you go into that waterfall dive that left me with my jaw on the floor. Literally, I was like, wow, that was amazing. And then the underwater photography. The costumes were great too. Having them come up and it was in this snow-capped area where these glaciers were. It was just really beautifully done. And the music fit the piece so well.
I really like the idea to go through nature and then dancing in the woods and then dancing on the ice and then moving from one place to another, which basically is just the short ends up being not just about the music and the performer, but also about the beautiful surroundings where the short is shot, the nature, the environment, how beautiful our planet is. And at the same time, these main characters, that these dancers that really know how to move, that really, we can see their passion in the performance, and the music that goes with the performance is perfect, because when you listen to that music, that's the kind of performance you're expecting.
This was bizarre. I'll give these actors, these dancers, major credit though, because they jumped into water and did scenes in water in a very, very cold climate. You can tell that through the snow. The cinematography is gorgeous. The music was absolutely beautiful.